Hello and welcome friends. In this particular module, we wish to discuss about the thermal processing techniques for energy and product recovery. In this particular presentation, we'll deal with the thermal processing techniques, namely pyrolysis and gasification. We'll discuss the theory, operation, the products that are to be derived through these particular processes, along with the advantages as well as disadvantages. We'll also discuss about the types of the reactors. And at the end, we'll have the comparison among combustion, pyrolysis, and gasification as thermal techniques. So as you learn the content, you'll be able to explain use of the pyrolysis as thermal technique for energy recovery from municipal solid waste. We'll also be able to explain use of the gasification as a thermal technique for energy recovery from municipal solid waste and compare the thermal technologies in terms of product and energy recovery. Thermal processing is the conversion of solid waste into gases, liquid, and solid conversion products with concurrent or subsequent release of heat energy. Namely, there are three technologies: combustion, pyrolysis, and gasification. Combustion is the thermal processing of the solid fuels by chemical oxidation with stoichiometric or excess amount of air to produce the heat. The pyrolysis is aimed at producing the combustible tar, bio oil, and char in the absence of the oxygen. Gasification produces the combustible gas, hydrogen, and certain synthetic fuels. Whenever we are going for this particular thermochemical conversion, principally we are making use of heat. As far as the kind of the waste which needs to be processed through these particular techniques, we have to attend their certain parameters, such as it has to be dry in form, it must have the volatile content greater than 40%, as well it must have the high energy values such as 1200 to 1800 kilocalorie per kg. Especially whenever we are dealing with the combustion, in order to make the oxidation self-sustainable, the waste must have the calorific value greater than 1800 kilocalorie per kg. As we have these particular parameters as compared to say this anaerobic digestion, we need the moisture content more. The fixed carbon must be less than 15%, and In order to facilitate the microbial actions, CYN ratio must be ranging in between 25 to 30. The major distinguishing feature as far as thermochemical convergence are associated with the calorific value. Let's discuss about the first technique, that is pyrolysis. This technique is also known as thermal decomposition, destructive distillation, or even decarbonization. In this, chemical decomposition is induced in organic materials by heat in the absence of the oxygen. The organic materials are transformed into the gaseous component and solid residue containing fixed carbon and ash. So the way you see here, this is certain thermal reactor in which pre-segregated waste or refuse derived fuel is added into this particular reactor, which is heated at the temperature more than 430 degrees centigrade in the absence of the oxygen, so that the gases that are forming will be leaving this particular reactor along with the particulate. As they are processed through certain cyclone, the produced char will be separated out of the process. The gaseous contents are further allowed to move to the quenching operations, so that it would be transformed into the bio-oil. The remnant gases are further circulated within the system so as to have the system sort of self-sustainable. As we wish to have this reactor fully oxygen starving, practically the waste contains some of the portion of the oxygen, and hence to achieve completely oxygen-free atmosphere within such a reactor is not possible. Through this particular pyrolysis, a gas stream containing primarily hydrogen, methane, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, and various other gases are produced. The extent of this particular gases will be depending on the organic characteristic of the material that will be pyrolyzing. A liquid fraction that is obtained through this particular pyrolysis consists of a tar or oil stream which further contain the acetic acid, acetone, methanol, and complex oxygenated hydrocarbons. So these needs to be processed so as to have the bio oil converted into synthetic fuel oil. The char, which is consisting of almost pure carbon plus some of the inert materials which are originally present in that particular solid waste. The yield of the products can be considered to be 30 to 60% condensates, gases 15 to 35%, and char 10 to 15%. Typically, the energy value of the bio oil that has been produced is estimated to be 5000 kilocalorie per kg. Under conditions of the maximum gas production, say at the temperature of 900 degrees centigrade, it has been estimated that the energy content of this particular resulting gas could be 3000 to 4,800 kilocalorie for normal meter cube. The industrial use of the pyrolysis, such as production of the charcoal from wood, coke, coke gas from coal, are very common processes. This particular technique for mixed plastic waste has very high application. As we think of this particular technology, status-wise, still it is in emerging phase. As we consider the data 2013-14, you can see here that mostly preferred option is combustion, which is 44%, whereas other thermal technologies are to the tune of say 15%. As the technology is still in developing phase, especially in low income group countries as well as the developing countries, this technology is not very popular because of the nature of the waste. Hence, the limited performance data is available for systems treating especially the hazardous waste. This particular technology has the potential to create the products of incomplete combustion, including the dioxins as well as furans, as these particular products are highly toxic as far as the atmospheric conditions are concerned. The performance is treated to be questionable. However, the basic concepts associated with the process obtaining the char biofuel are validated, and hence the variety of the pyrolysis units are still in developing phase and are being studied on the pilot scale basis. So as we try to understand the classification and the types of the pyrolysis units, it can be considered to be conventional, which is slow pyrolysis, fast pyrolysis, and ultra-fast or flash pyrolysis. The temperature ranges which are used are 400 to 500 degrees centigrade as far as conventional techniques are concerned. In the fast pyrolysis, this could be 400 to 650 degrees centigrade. And ultra-fast, the temperature range could be 700 to 1000 degrees centigrade. For each of these, as you see, there is a considerable difference as far as the residence time is concerned. In the conventional techniques, that could be 5 to 30 minutes, whereas for flash pyrolysis, it could be even the less than 0.5 seconds. The heating rates are also distinguished according to the method that we go for. The major products, as you see, are gases, char, bio oil. However, their characteristics will change as we have the different temperature changes, different temperature ranges. Also, the kind of the reactor that we'll be using could be rotary kiln, rotary hot furnace. It could also be the fluid bed furnace. The molten salt destruction technique is extension to pyrolysis technique. This can be taken as thermal non-flame, a process capable of oxidizing the organic constituents of variety of the waste, such as radioactive waste, mixed waste, hazardous waste, and certain energetic materials while retaining the inorganic and radioactive constituents in the salt, which is molten carbonate. This technique uses a molten turbulent bed of salt such as sodium carbonate as a heat transfer and reaction scrubbing medium to destroy the hazardous materials. As we see in this particular schematic diagram, the shredded solid waste is injected with air under the surface of the molten salt. The hot gases, composed primarily of carbon dioxide, steam, and unreacted air components, rise through this molten salt path, pass through the secondary reaction zone, and through an off-gas cleanup system before discharging it into the waste. All other gases in their highest oxidation state are acidic and thus react with this molten carbonate, and accordingly they remain in the melt only. The spent molten salt containing the ash is tapped from the reactor, cooled, and it is further processed either through landfills or some other applications. Plasma pyrolysis vitrification or plasma arc process is also one of the types as extended technique of pyrolysis. It is an emerging technology utilizing the thermal decomposition of the organic waste for energy as well as resource recovery. The way we see here, it comprises the reactor which has further zones of gasification and freeboard zone. In this particular reactor, the waste is fed from the top in order to move in the downward direction. There are two plasma arc torches through the application of the voltage between the electrodes. It creates very high voltage discharge, and consequently the temperature within this particular zone rises to 5000 to 14000 degrees centigrade. This hot plasma zone dissociates the molecules of any organic material which comes into the contact and transform into the elemental atoms. The syngas such generated through the gasification operation can be used for the generation of electricity. The gasification technique is very similar to the pyrolysis, but it is characterized with the high temperatures, usually more than 1000 degrees centigrade. Basically, such techniques improves the heating value of gases output. These techniques involve the thermal decomposition of the organic matter at very high temperatures in the reactors. The gas which is generated is a mixture of combustible as well as non-combustible gases, and hence they need further cleansing so as to obtain the clean syngas which can further be utilized in IC engines to generate the electricity. This particular technology uses the limited amount of air and oxygen for the decomposition of the organic matter in the high temperature. The technology as such is established under various controls, and hence the emissions are very less. As such, it has got more public acceptance. Also, this particular technology is more flexible as compared to the incineration. This particular technology, when employed with steam, attains the name of reforming and results in a hydrogen and carbon dioxide rich synthetic gas. The gasification primarily involves five reactions, the three of which are exothermic in nature, whereas two of them are endothermic in nature. The heat to sustain the process is derived from the exothermic reactions, whereas the combustible components are primarily generated by endothermic reactions. In the gasification, the formations of the dioxins as well as the oxides of sulfur as well as the oxides of the nitrogen are limited, because essentially these reactions take place in very low oxygen environment. The nitrogen or the sulfur in the waste stream end up as hydrogen sulfide, nitrogen or ammonia rather than oxides of sulfur or oxides of nitrogen. The gasification typically occurs through these particular five steps. As we see in this particular schematic sketch, the solid waste is fed to the vacuum holding tank, which is preheated and heated to this furnace. The volatile matter is gasified and fed directly to this particular plasma arc generator. It is passed through the plasma arc, dissociating into the elemental stages such as hydrogen, carbon dioxide, and water. These gas outputs are further cleaned through the various cleansing operations in order to have the clean synthetic gas along with the components such as methanol, ammonia as such. This gasification has got distinguished advantages. It has got very high environmental as well as economic potential, essentially because the technique utilizes the renewable resources through carbon neutral mode. It utilizes the waste materials which has got certain lumber processing or agricultural residues. Also, it is having the self-sustaining energy. Through this particular technology, the low energy in the biomass is converted into the high energy density liquid fuels, and also it has got potential to produce the chemicals from bio-based resources. Through this particular gasification, the process can generate the low calorific value gas containing 10% of carbon dioxide, 20% of carbon monoxide, 15% of hydrogen and 2% of methane with the balance of nitrogen. The second product is char, which is containing the carbon and inerts, which are originally present in the salt waste. The third component is condensable liquid, which is resembling the pyrolytic oil. The gasification process are quite stable with fairly constant quality of the gas, which is produced over the broad range of air inputs. Also, this particular technology can employ pure oxygen instead of air, and accordingly, high calorific value gas can be generated through the process. The technology may employ various types of gasifiers, which are vertical bed type, horizontal bed type, and fluidized bed type. The vertical fixed bed gasifier, as shown schematically here, the uniform feed such as densified refuse derived fuel enters into the reactor through the gravity in the downward direction, whereas it comes across the concurrent flow of the air. As the products are gasified at the requisite temperatures, it produces low calorie gas and char. Some controls could be established over the processes that are occurring in order to avoid and minimize the environmental impacts. Also, in these vertical bed gasifiers, one can use the oxygen instead of air. As we see this horizontal fixed bed gasifier, essentially it comprises of the two chambers. One is primary combustion chamber and secondary combustion chamber. This primary combustion chamber is gasifying the waste at substoichiometric level so as to produce the low calorie gas, whereas the second chamber assists to have this low calorie gas combusted with excess air to generate the heat, which in turn is used through the boilers in order to generate the electricity. The third category is fluidized bed gasifiers. As we discussed about the fluidized bed combustors, the same can be slightly modified in order to make use of the reactors as in the form of fluidized bed gasifiers. Here, there is a necessity of the small particle size in order to make them in the suspension. As the process takes place, the generated flue is passed through the air control mechanism in order to have them for the running of the gas turbines in order to generate the electricity. Further, the leftovers are also used in order to run the boilers in turn to generate the electricity. Here, the technique as such is very clean, and hence it has got quite a potential in order to have the further developments as the future technology. As we see here in this sketch, it is representing pyrolysis, gasification, as well as combustion. Pyrolysis occurs in the absence of the oxygen in order to form char gases as well as tar, whereas The gasification is the process which occurs at the substoichiometric level, and for the combustion we have to provide the excess air in order to facilitate the combustion reaction. As we see here in this particular sketch, the pyrolysis process gives us char, tar, and even the gas which can be used further to have the products derived, extracted out of the process, as well as energy also produced through that. The combustion is meant simply to have the heat in order to use it through the boilers in order to generate the electricity, whereas this gasification technique is very versatile, as it is further elaborated in this particular case. It is helpful to have the medium heating value gas, low heating value gas, which can further be used in order to run the turbines as well as the boilers in order to generate the electricity. Through synthesis, the technology has got potential to generate the methanol, hydrogen, as well as even the fuel alcohol. As such, as the technology has got many applications, this is preferred over the pyrolysis as well as combustion. The kind of the peculiarities associated with the combustion, gasification and pyrolysis are compiled in this particular tabular statement, the way we discuss through various slides. So, thanks for your attention. I hope the concepts that we discussed associated with the thermal processing are clear to you. As we move ahead, we will discuss about the combustion for waste to energy. So, why till then? I wish you very happy learning. Thank you.